Today I'm going to talk about what to expect or what to observe when you're working with someone who is actively dying. Everyone is unique and different on their end of life experience. However, there's some basic similarities that you can expect. We have a book that we receive from hospice called Gone from Sight, The Dying Experience. And this is available at any of our branches if you would like that for your own reference. But essentially, 3 to 6 months after someone will pass away, they are getting a little bit more tired, more short of breath, more confusion, so forth. About a month before, even sleeping a little bit more. Several weeks before they pass away, they may be talking to people that we cannot see or hallucinating. They typically don't eat as much. They are sleeping a lot more. And typically days within passing, they get their last hurrah. They get this big burst of energy. So say they've been sleeping and almost non-responsive for 1 week. And all of a sudden they're sitting up, they're talking to everybody, they eat a full meal, they're calling family members. And this gives family a false hope that they're getting better. But it's really nature's way of letting them tie up their loose ends, say their goodbyes, and so forth before they pass away. So it's really quite a gift. So just making sure family has realistic expectations regarding what's going on with their loved one. So hours and minutes before passing away, you will see skin changes because the internal organs are trying to conserve life. So they will shunt blood away from the legs and from the arms to work with all the core tissues. So there may be some skin changes that may look blotchy, blue, black, purple, maybe cold. This is normal. And there may be less urine flow or no urine coming out. So usually the kidneys are the first organs to shut down. And there may be some breathing changes, maybe periods where they're breathing very quickly, periods where they're not breathing, or maybe a combination between the two. They may also have sound like they have more cough or congestion. There are great medications to help reduce those secretions and improve their breathing rate and rhythm so that they are very comfortable. So again, if you ever have questions, please give us a call, give hospice a call. We're always there to support you and want to make sure you don't feel like you're alone. I've created a whole hospice packet that is task-oriented for actively dying end-of-life cares. So we have that here at the office. Please call us, we can get it to you. So you will be working on a specific care need task every 2 hours. And there are multiple of them. So basically you go through all of the tasks, two hours has passed, and go through the other tasks as well.